and it is incumbent upon governments to protect their constituents, whether it be a federal, state, or local law. We are not above the law. We all have to follow the law. So when you have a business who decides that they're going to put themselves above the law, it's going to cause dissension. We were listed in a position paper as being a number of uninformed citizens. I resent that label because I think that we are informed, and I think the number is greater than was insinuated in that paper. We walked our neighborhood, we spoke with people, and we asked them, do you want this in your neighborhood? And they did not. Some people are afraid to talk, and for good reasons, and we respect that. But most of the people did not want this. They know it's not a good thing. There are examples all around us, and I really can sympathize, or rather empathize, with Mr. Mike Shaft, because my son was one of those who had to move out of Bayou Corn. A beautiful place. It was beautiful in the summer, it was beautiful in the winter, and he built that place with his own hands. It had chickens running around when he first came there, and anybody who saw that place would love to have lived there. So I can appreciate Mr. Shaft's emotion. I certainly can, because my son felt the same way. He's gonna have to relocate as well. The question was, what are the possible negative effects on the land values? And the answer FAS gave is actually ludicrous. It's laughable. The only good that will come out of this accrues to FAS, not to the residents. There is no way that a toxic waste company located 1/2 mile from your house can enhance your property values. Get real. Okay, given the size, this is my last point that I want to make. Given the size of the monetary investment in this proposal, it is conceivable that this company would make projections for the future. Any business does this. They project when they lay out that amount of money as to what I'm going to do, what can I possibly do in the future. So I say that it's not inconceivable that at some point in the future, this company could ask for a well on the Belle River side, because where that location is that they're proposing to put this facility, the river is very, very wide, and it could accommodate large barges. And what we would have now is all this fracking material coming from the northern states and any other state where they want to come dump it in St. Martin Parish. We do not need this in St. Martin Parish. We don't need it in Belle River. And I'm going to conclude with this. Where is this going to end if they get a permit? If they can come in, other industries can come in, and the first thing you know, we live in this industrialized area that we really don't want to live in. We live in Belle River because we like the peace and quiet. So I'm asking, please consider people. The issue is people. The issue is not bricks and mortar, it's people. And, you know, as we go, more and more, there's less people for people to live. So consider, why do you need a business if you don't have people in the community? Thank you for listening.